Merry Christmas. Welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie. I'm Norma Nelson, hosting tonight with Terry Richardson. And also with Dave and Patty, they're joining us all the way from
Washington.
Yeah. But we're going to do a little Christmas song, and then Dave and Patty, I think, are joining us. Ryan, put some music on. Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
Well, maybe we'll wait on the song.
Oh, here it comes.
Oh, it's coming. Okay.
I hear some music.
Oh, I hear it too.
Thank you, Norma. That was by request. It's great to have Patty and Dave with us, coming all the way from Washington on Skype. How you doing, Patty and Dave?
Hey, we're doing good. Can you hear us?
Yeah, and you even look good from here. Yeah, that's, I could see you pretty good. This must be good spectacles.
We have a couple of ladies high that are coming, and so that's why we have this empty chair here. So one of them just stepped in. We'll have the other one here shortly, I believe.
Who's that good-looking fellow sitting beside you there?
Yeah, we've got Rhonda that's joining us here, and she we met her just recently with the Muscle Shoot Tribe, and you were there. You've seen miracles, and you saw you guys went and prayed for different people. Can you tell us about that?
Well, I've never experienced anything like this before. And I was, I went the first day and I seen some miracles, happen right before my eyes, which made me even a more believer in God. And, I missed the second day, but I went the third day and, I asked Dave if he could pray for my daughter-in-law. And,
he went to the hospital and he prayed for her. And she got home, sent home the next day.
Oh, praise God.
Praise the Lord.
It's all God. And she was healed.
But you kept declaring it. Actually, I really didn't pray for it. You and Susie did.
Yeah, and then on our way home, I seen the biggest miracle that really, truly made me believe that God is real. And on our way home, we almost seen an accident. But it was like God's hand reached out and grabbed that truck. And there was no accident. But I know what I saw, and it was real.
Four-lane interstate. They had a four-lane interstate, this semi, or this straight truck like a semi, and it slid sideways, and both ladies just started declaring that nobody was going to get hurt. There was not going to be. They just declared it. And four lanes of interstate just skidded to a stop. Nobody got hurt or hit. The truck did hit his bumper on the guardrail, and then he backed up and drove away.
Amen.
Wow. That's a miracle.
That's really a miracle.
I wasn't there, but I heard him say both the ladies just put their hand up, and they just declared over it. And there was a miracle.
There was a miracle.
They asked me how to do it, and I said, just like you just did.
Just like you just did. I love it.
Just do it again the next time, and the next time you got it.
Same thing, yeah.
Amen.
Well, it can't be that simple. I said, yeah, it is. You just declare God's word and believe it, and bang, it happened.
Amen.
I felt it.
Yeah, praise God.
And when she started sharing the testimony, she just walked into the room, and you could just see the power of God hitting her as she was testifying how God had used her and others.
Yeah.
Amen.
God is wonderful. God is great.
Mm-hmm. So do you remember some of the other people that were healed? We had a healing service three nights in a row.
What's the first one?
I had this little girl come to the youth program, and she was blind in one eye, and her eye was all white, and she couldn't see out of that eye. But that first night, Patty prayed for her, and Dave prayed for her, and the little girl was able to see out of her eye.
We're getting a bit of a broken signal here, Patty and Dave, with Skype. There, it cleared up.
I can't hear.
We apologize. A little bit of technical. I think Skype's kind of busy the last few days. Awesome what Rhonda is sharing, and it's awesome what Dave and Patty are doing. They're teaching the word, and here's a scripture. And it's talking about Jesus, okay? And that's the reason for the season, Jesus Christ. Here's what it says. For God's will was for us to be made holy by the sacrifice of the body of Jesus Christ once for all time. He made us holy, and we could be like him, and we are his children. And he said to his children as a good father, he said, go and do what I've done and do more. I think we're back now with Patty and Dave, but I'm just giving scripture on what God's doing through them.
Amen.
Welcome back.
Amen. Welcome back. So, and the little girl, she said all she could see at first was just like really bright light.
Yes.
And so I had other little kids lay their hands on her and just blast her with the power of the Holy Spirit, and they'd never done any of this before. This was all new to them. And it got better. She said, I can see you have brown hair. I'm like, you're right, I do. I kept like sticking my face in hers, like looking in her eye, you know. And then we blasted her a few more times, different kids. And she lives in a foster home, and so I had all of the little kids. There's like six or eight of them. Mm-hmm. I had them all come up and just blasting her. And then I put my face in her face again, and she says, I can see your makeup. Like, oh, praise God. Yahoo. And her foster mom came up, and she was just crying. She was just thrilled. So that's a pretty pretty good one there.
Yes.
Praise God. Yeah. And I did talk to Alex and Kaylin, the ones that we were staying with, and she had bloody noses so bad she was gone to the emergency room, they had like packed her nose, and it was like, oof, icky. And they just went back to the doctor today, and they said when they brought her in, they would possibly have to do surgery on her. And when she came to the third night, the healing service, she said she actually knew that she wasn't going to have the surgery. And this morning when I, or this afternoon when I talked to her husband, he said that they did not have to do any surgery, that it was fine. Everything was just fine. So praise God.
Amen.
That was good news. So, do you remember other people that were healed?
Well, my sister-in-law came, and about 4 years ago, she got really sick, and she had a torn aorta, and she's on heart medication and blood pressure medication, and they laid hands on her the third day, and she was with us before we went to the hospital, and he laid hands on her and prayed for her, mm-hmm. and after we went to the hospital, she said she was sitting at home, and she could feel inside where her heart, the torn aorta, and she could feel it like somebody was pinching it inside. She said it was like it was being put back together. And she believed she was healed because she could feel that, like it was being put back together inside her. And she's been feeling good ever since.
Oh, praise God.
Praise God.
That's cool. We love to hear the things after the fact. Sometimes we don't hear everything during the meeting, you know, but we hear things after the fact. So, praise God. There's just so many things that we get to hear about.
I know. What was it like when you started speaking in tongues for the first time?
I'll share with you that I've never felt something so wonderful in my life. That was when I first met them. I walked up to Dave, and he said, "Do you speak in tongues?" And I kind of looked at him like, "What are you talking about? I don't know what you're talking about." And he said, "You're going to speak in tongues." And I'm just like, okay, you know, whatever. And then the third night, I came, and I was sitting in the back with my husband and my cousin. And my cousin looked at me, and she said, "Do you speak in tongues?" And I looked at her, and I said, "No." And she says, "You're going to." And I thought, okay. And then so at the end of the evening, they called us all up there and said, okay, we're going to pray and we're going to speak in tongue. I don't remember the exact words, but I thought, okay, I'll try this. I'll see. And they had me put my hand on my stomach, and I closed my eyes, and I was praying, and I was trying to repeat after Patty, and I could hardly hear her. And then I heard her say, "Open your mouth wider." And that's all I remember when she told me to open my mouth wider. When I opened my mouth, all this stuff was just flowing out of me, and I couldn't control it, and it was coming out of me, and pretty soon I could feel like, I don't even know how to explain it, it was like power through my body, like a good power, a good feeling. Mm-hmm. And after that happened to me, I feel like I have God in me so bright.
Amen.
So much now that I just, everywhere I go, I talk about God, and I talk about the miracles that he can do and the wonderful things he can do for you. He's real, and he is so powerful, and it is just so such a blessing for me to be here. I just truly believe it's good.
Praise God. Yep.
I wish there were all as easy as you were. I mean, you stepped right into it, started doing it.
Amen. You know, the funny thing is, when you said that, I said, "Open your mouth wider." I never said that.
And that's what I heard. I heard somebody say, "Open your mouth wider," and then I
told you that.
It wasn't me.
God.
I never said that.
So when I heard that, opened my mouth wider, and I just went to do it, and then, like I said, those words just, they were uncontrollable. They just flowed and flowed and flowed and flowed.
Praise God.
I feel so good now that I've never felt this good in all my life.
Oh, praise God.
I feel it every day. I mean, I get up and I feel so good.
Amen.
I can't explain the feeling, but it's just wonderful.
Well, we really enjoyed being with everybody. You know, everybody is very loving and warm and made us feel at home. And, you know, it's, we did the 3-day DHT and then three nights of healing service every night. And then after we left, they're like, we want you to come back. They knew we were doing a three-day DHT. It's about an hour away. And they said, can you come back afterwards? And we're like, sure. There was so many people that got healed. And
that's the first thing you said.
There's so many people that that still need healing. So praise God. We are so glad to be back here and to touch the people. They have a lot of oppression and a lot of things coming against them around here. And we
but
just
no more.
Yeah. No more. We're just kicking Satan's butt right and left. And we're having fun doing it too.
Amen.
Amen.
All they are is little devils. There's no big devils. They're just little defeated devils.
Yep. Amen.
Go.
Jesus.
Yep. And they've had some experiences with some resistance since we were here. And so it's like, you know what? You just keep walking in it, and there's no big devils. Like he said, you just tell them to go in Jesus' name. Because
Amen.
With the Jesus in you, you have more power and authority than any devil. So you just Amen. Tell them to go in Jesus' name. It's just that, you know, sometimes it's hard when you don't really get that. You have that authority, and they do. Amen. They have that authority, and Susie, she was hit head on with it, but she just walked right through it, and she did a great job, and I'm so proud of her. And, you know, of course Satan likes to test us if he can, and she passed the test. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
And she's going to keep doing it, too. So y'all are.
Yep, amen.
Yeah, I just keep lifting you guys up in prayer, and I said, we just station angels round about all of them in Jesus' name. First I said to all the Christians that are here on the reservation, then I said, well, that's not very nice. Lord, just station angels around all of them. The rest of them need to get set free, too.
Amen.
Amen. So, it's not his will that any of us suffer or
right,
perish.
Exactly.
Amen.
What happened to your friend that had a stroke and hadn't walked in years?
Oh, she was able to take two steps forward and two steps back. She can move her arm. She's talking better.
All right.
Pretty good.
Yep, real good.
What happened when we were at
her
house? The lady with the tailbone?
Yeah, her friend of hers was at her house when she when we got there, and she had fell and hurt her tailbone, and she's pregnant, and she could hardly move. And, you know, Dave and Susie put hands on her, and she was able to get up and walk.
Amen.
Yeah.
And the other friend that was there.
The other gentleman that was there, I don't know who he is, but I could tell he was troubled when we walked in the room because he wouldn't look at us. He wouldn't give us eye contact. He wouldn't look at us, and he kind of just turned away. And then Dave kept asking him, is there something with you? Can we pray for you? And then finally he came out, and he said that he can't sleep at night, that evil troubled him, and he was bothered, and it was telling him that somebody was going to go next, and he was really scared. You could tell that he was frightened.
Mm-hmm.
But after they prayed for him, he smiled. He felt good. He felt really
praise
good.
God.
He started paying attention and looking at us and giving us eye contact, but he was healed. He's not in fear no more because God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Set free of that fear and pain.
It's about that time, Patty, but I got a verse that backs up everything that Rhonda's saying.
All right.
Romans 8:2, and because you belong to him, the power of the life-giving spirit has freed you from the power of sin that leads to death. He's been set free by the power of God through Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
It's time for our first break, and we'll be right back.
Thank you.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
celebrate the light. When I stumble in the darkness,
call your name by night.
I will call your name by night.
God of wonders beyond our galaxy, you are holy, holy. The universe declares your majesty. You are.
Hello, I'm Mike Politoski with Praise Broadcasting Network. For the finest in praise and worship music, visit us at www.pbnradio.com. We at PBN are proud supporters of Dave and Patty Loggie, Holy Spirit-led ministries, and we encourage you to prayerfully consider doing the same. You can visit their website at hslm.us and click the donate button and be a part of helping Dave and Patty reaching out to thousands of hurting people all across the United States of America. You know, the Great Commission of Jesus has no boundaries and no borders, and it takes enormous expenses to move a ministry like HSLM across the country. Would you like to be a part of it? We certainly would appreciate it. Join us in supporting Holy Spirit-led ministries by visiting www.hslm.us and click the donate button. Thank you and God bless you.
Welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie. I'm Norma again and Terry.
Hello.
And Dave and Patty are with us with their friend Rhonda has also been with us tonight.
Yeah, thank you. And right now we're in Auburn, Washington. We were here, we went to Silverdale, and we've been in Vancouver. We've been all over, praise God. And that was really a cool commercial. That's the first time we've seen it.
How'd awesome. You like that? Didn't Mike do a good job?
Yeah, he's so good at that stuff. Praise God for Mike. He's just terrific. Well, Rhonda said something to us while we were on the commercial break, and we're hoping that she can repeat it again.
Well, I've been thinking and I've been praying, and I believe that God sent Dave and Patty here to help our people, to pray for our people and heal our people and show miracles so the people will find God.
Yes.
Because right now, a lot of our people don't know God, mm-hmm. and they have nowhere and nobody, and they really have a hard life. Mm-hmm. And I truly believe that
They were sent here to show the people that God is real, that he's real and he's alive and he could be anywhere. And I believe that once they're gone from here, that our people are going to look to God more and they're going to believe. I truly believe that.
Amen. We're agreeing with you, Rhonda. You're very spiritual people anyway, and you are the children of God. We just need to get... That's what Patty and Dave are doing. They're awakening you to who you are, because you do come down. You came from the Father of Lights. Amen?
Amen. Praise God. Yeah. We really enjoyed being with everybody here. And, you know, the kids, we had the kids come up front at the beginning of the first service, and we had all the adults come up that needed prayer, and we had them praying for them. And just blast them with the power of the Holy Spirit. And some of them, they didn't, like, believe in this kind of stuff. But when they saw the kids doing it and people getting healed, they believed. It wasn't just Dave and Patty. And we had other people come up that were praying, too, that were adults. And so they saw that there are people doing it, you know. And Amen. We had the teenagers coming up, and they were laying hands on the sick and seeing them recover, and they thought that was really neat. Oh, the young girl. What's her name? It's Susie's daughter. Oh, it's Susan.
Oh, Susan. Yeah. Susan. Yeah.
Yeah. She had hurt her ankle playing basketball, and so they took her to the emergency room. Susie was with us at the healing service, and so her husband went down to the hospital. And she didn't really know what all was going on, but Dave prayed for her over the phone, and she felt better. And then she came the next night to the healing service, and then we prayed for her in person. And then the next night, she went back to practice.
Mm-hmm.
And the coach and all of her teammates were so surprised, and they're like, how could you do that? And she's like, they prayed for me, and Jesus healed me. And
Amen.
So then she got to spread the word of the gospel.
Yep. Amen.
That was just amazing. That is just so cool. When the teenagers are not afraid to talk about it,
we couldn't have a choice because everybody knew you got hurt. They figured you're going to be on crutches. The next night, you're playing basketball again.
Well, that's what the doctor said. He said she'd be on crutches for at least a week.
Yep.
And
wearing a boot.
Yeah. And she, all the pain left. It was totally healed. And she was practicing. It's just like, oh, thank you, Jesus. That was so neat.
Yep. And, you know, there's another thing I experienced. She brought a young girl in there, another young teenager. And they had them standing in front of us. And I was the one getting prayed for. And these young people would come along and they'd, you know, rotate down the line. This one girl came, and earlier this, well, it's been about a year now since she lost her sister to leukemia, and she's been struggling with, you know, a lot of sorrow and a lot of probably hurt.
Mm-hmm.
And she got to me, and she grabbed my hand, and I don't know what I felt, but I think God was working through me to put belief and strength into her, because when she tried to let go of my hands, and I tried to let go of her hands, we couldn't let go of each other.
Uh-huh.
And I cried.
That sounds like some power.
She cried, and it was like he was healing her through me.
Yeah.
To give her strength.
Yeah.
To give her comfort. Because and she told me, she hugged me and hugged me and hugged me afterwards and said, thank you, you know. And I felt it. I know what I felt.
Right.
I felt good go into her, and it was wonderful. It was good.
Praise God. That's so cool. There was many, many people that were there. And I know that there was one of the elders, a young man, and I know his mother? She had the long hair, really thin. She had a white top on. Oh, maybe
the first night when you went back to the back and you prayed for him?
I don't know. I think it was the first night. She came up front and got prayed for, and she felt a whole lot better. And I don't know, maybe it was the second night. Maybe you weren't there.
No, I don't think I was there the second night.
Well, he was one of the elders, and he really saw God move in a mighty way. with I believe his mom, and so
that was the second night. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. Susie shared that with me, and the same thing happened to her. That happened to me, but I think it happened to her.
She got filled with the Holy Spirit. You mean?
Yeah,
yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Praise God.
Yeah, the first night that I asked people to come up.
We lost sound again here. Thank you for being patient. We love Skype, but sometimes the technical issues. But I want to go to Scripture to share with you what she's describing, what's happening. Now, Paul said it to the Philippians in chapter 3, verse 10. You notice I'm all over Scripture? The reason is because the Scripture confirms what we're doing, and we do the Scripture.
Amen.
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 We're just not teaching off the top of our head. We're doing Scripture. I want to know Christ and the experience, the mighty power that raised him from the dead. I will experience the resurrection from the dead. That's out of Philippians chapter 3, starting with verse 10. Patty, it sounds like you're back.
Yes, amen. Thank you, Terry.
Yes.
I don't know what's happening here, obviously.
You know what? Thank Terry. He makes us look good.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
No, it's Nora that makes you look good. You know, I'm just...
Well, both of you.
Praise God.
I got to hear Norm singing. Woohoo!
Amen. Amen.
The guy that, and there was another elder there, where it's not something that they've done before. The elders haven't made it to the different healing services or different ministers that have been in. So that was a miracle in itself. To get them there. After the one had been there the first night, then the second night, another one came, and their family members got prayed for.
Mm-hmm.
And I have to tell you, one of the persons in the back row, when I went to pray for him, because he wouldn't come forward, I asked, you know, if there's something that he needed. And he said no. And I said, you know, when it's a guy, sometimes I kind of tease him a little bit. And I said, I promise I won't hurt you. And he said, no, but I might hurt you.
Oh. Praise God. Rhonda shared just earlier, she was sharing her heart about Dave and Patty coming and being sent to them there with the Muckleshoot tribe. But when she made a statement, that was actually prophetic. Because she said they came to bring that light and bring the power and the presence of Jesus. Now, the beautiful thing about this is that Rhonda herself is going to show forth the light. And she's already doing the signs and wonders. Amen?
Amen.
She's actually working in signs and wonders. And Rhonda, how many years of Bible college did you have?
I went to college for about 4 or 5 years. I'm a business owner now, and I'm mm-hmm. just an at-home grandma and wife.
But how about theological school? Any Bible school or anything like that?
No, nothing. I just have God in, right here.
You just have God right there. Okay, that's where you need him, and
amen.
He will speak through you. You need the words walking. Go ahead, guys. Come on back.
I truly believe that. He's going to lead me to lead my people to
come on.
A better life.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
To have
yes.
God in their life.
Yeah.
Yes.
They have, unfortunately, a lot of addictions here, a suicide.
No more.
Let's speak no to more. That. We're supposed no to more. Declare. That's what the Spirit said. Dave,
that's right.
Lead us in that. We're supposed to declare that's broken over the nations,
amen.
Over that time. Go ahead. You and Rhonda. You guys all start speaking,
please
declaring.
All that suicide is going to stop right
yes,
now in the name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
Amen.
Drug abuse, you go,
go.
Right now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Addictions, you go right now in Jesus'
yes,
name.
In the name of Jesus.
Every
yes.
knee will bow now to the name of Jesus.
Yes. Amen. Yes. And these amen. Parents are going to step into being parents like
yes.
they're supposed to be.
Amen.
All that addiction is going to be gone, and they're just going to step
name.
Up to the plate. And they're going to have their heart after God. It's just going to totally
amen.
Change. We're breaking off all that junk. And Jesus is just going to rule
name.
And reign over this Indian reservation.
Amen.
There's nothing else.
Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
And they are going to know their Heavenly Father.
Yeah.
Right? Just keep it on them. They're going to know their Heavenly Father. They're going to know the one they've been crying out to, and He's going to appear to them, and He is powerful, and He is going to reach the nations. You feel that? And He's going to quicken your nation, and He's going to shift the atmosphere in that whole region. And I'm telling you, we went into the Lakota tribe, had 45% of the children were trying to commit suicide. And we did prayer walks, and we did declarations. And we worked with a guy named Tom that you guys know real well. And the bottom line is they surveyed afterwards a year later and found out less than 2% tried it that next year. It dropped from 45, 50% to 2%.
Amen.
So, yes, make those declarations, Rhonda. You're right on. You're just speaking by the Spirit of God in Jesus' name.
Amen. Yeah.
Well, I keep getting Job 22:28, where it says, if you declare a thing, it will be established.
That's it. That's it.
Amen.
No more.
No more.
Yeah, ever since we've been here, I just keep declaring things over this place, and I'm just going to continue to do that, too, you know?
Amen. Amen.
I had a cousin that was full-blooded Indian, and so, you know, and these people, they're just dear to my heart since we've got to meet them, and, you know, it's like, it was so hard before, but, you know, we're just going to help change it with the Jesus in us, and it's just going to be so different. And we're going to come back in a year, and this place is just going to be sparkling.
Amen.
Yeah.
I talked to Pete Mackey, and at first it sounded funny because he's part Indian. He goes over to the by the Omaha area.
Yeah.
He said, hey, he had a meeting at the jail in over 2 weeks. I said, well, what happened? He said, well, there's nobody in jail anymore. There's only two people in the whole jail.
Oh,
yeah, he said that on our Skype group. Yes, yes.
Awesome, oh, awesome. Wow.
What's he been declaring? Yeah, come on, Rhonda, declare that over your nation.
Oh,
yeah. Declare that over those children.
To the, I think it's the Omaha tribe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They're going to build up a new jail, so he's going to have a brand new place to work.
Yeah, and the first thing is walk around that thing, make declarations. That thing stays empty.
Amen.
Of the nations. That the nations from this country will not be going occupying that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, golly, it's time for a commercial again. These things just keep popping up.
Praise God.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
If your knowledge of the Word of God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are. Let me ask you something. Is the fivefold ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you. What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
Hello, I'm Mike Politoski with Praise Broadcasting Network. For the finest in praise and worship music, visit us at www.pbnradio.com. We at PBN are proud supporters of Dave and Patty Logging, Holy Spirit-led ministries, and we encourage you to prayerfully consider doing the same. You can visit their website at hslm.us and click the donate button and be a part of helping Dave and Patty reaching out to thousands of hurting people all across the United States of America. You know, the Great Commission of Jesus has no boundaries and no borders, and it takes enormous expenses to move a ministry like HSLM across the country. Would you like to be a part of it? We certainly would appreciate it. Join us in supporting Holy Spirit-led ministries by visiting www.hslm.us and click the donate button. Thank you and God bless you.
What an awesome. I love that.
Oh, great.
That's great. Welcome back to I Believe in Miracles and Merry Christmas.
And we're back to Washington. I want to hear more. It sounds like they're rocking and rolling out there, Ryan.
A new world record.
Say again. The sound cut off. Go ahead and say that again. We're back here in Iowa. Now, here's the great thing about our technology is that we're in Iowa, and now then we'll be in Washington. But here's a beautiful scripture, what's happening. This is God's will for all people. As Patty said, she's praying for the Christians, and God said, what about all the people that don't know me? God's will was for us to be made holy by the sacrifice of the body of Jesus Christ once for all time. Now, that's out of Hebrews chapter 10. Once for all time, it's God's will that not any perish, but his sacrifice was for all people. Understand, for by that one offering he forever made perfect those who are being made holy. God paid it once for all. And when Jesus said it's paid for, he meant the whole thing. Now, here's the interesting point. It's your choice. God loves you so much, he gave us a free choice. Someone came to me one time and said, Pastor Terry or Uncle Terry, whatever country I was at, they said, you know, why do good people do bad things and why do bad people do good things? And I don't understand this. And I said, God loved us so much, he gave us free will. And that free will, he loves us so much, but he gave his son willingly so much that if you just reach out, if you just say the name of Jesus and ask Jesus to come in and touch you. See, it's no mystery. It's not even complicated. Man has complicated. Religion complicates it. But Jesus was not complicated.
Yes.
He came very simply, very clearly, and he gave everything so that you could have everything. He died that we could be reconciled back to our Father, which is God. I told a group just a few weeks ago at a memorial service for this dear one's mom, who already was in heaven, and I said, you're not from here.
Amen.
Amen. Every baby comes down from heaven. Now, yes, we're born into sin, and there is original sin, but the bottom line is God came to redeem us and to take us back home and to dwell with him. And here's the good news. I don't have to die for the kingdom to come.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Norma, tell us a couple testimonies. You've had some recent testimonies right here in Iowa.
Yes. Well, my field is mostly, or I should say my mission field, is a lot of the time at work. And so I've got to pray for some people recently in the last week. One of the gals was feeling very, very sick. And she said she was getting ready to go home, and it was the same day we were going to have our Christmas party. And I was like, well, that doesn't sound like the right thing. Let's pray. And she was feeling like nausea and flu symptoms. And I spoke to that, and she was better. She says, wow, all the nausea left me. I feel better. And I got to talk to her today, and she said, yeah, everything left her, and she was fine.
No Theraflu, no nothing. Just bam.
No. See, and she's a nurse.
Yeah.
So that was pretty awesome.
Hallelujah. A specialist in the medical field, yeah.
Yeah. So that was pretty cool. Another lady, not feeling good. She says, yeah, I always get this crud, and then it lingers forever. And we spoke to it, and I saw her today, and she seems pretty much normal. And
Amen. Normally,
like, loses the voice and all
that
kind of
stuff.
Tell
it can't linger. Here's the simple thing. We're the children of God. We're holy by the blood of Jesus Christ. And Jesus says we don't have to be sick. He paid for it.
He suffered
the stripes on his back. They beat him. They plucked his beard. I can't even imagine plucking the beard. But he suffered that, and he paid for the whole thing.
Yes.
The whole person.
Yeah.
So it was instant. It's instantaneous.
Instant. And my daughter, that's yes. another one this week.
Yeah, tell about Tiffany. Yeah.
She just was under attack. I mean, she had pain in her chest, up in her shoulder, up in her jaw, in her back. And she's young. She's 33. So, I mean, but we spoke to that right away. And I also sent out a message to other team members, and everybody responded instantly. And she's doing fine. She's absolutely fine. She hasn't had any reoccurrence of that. So I'm just grateful to God. Because when it's your own child, when it's your own family, you know, sometimes we, I don't know, we can have a little doubt or a little fear, but God just takes that away. And
I hear that Patty chuckle.
I know.
It's Washington's back. There they are. Oh. They're back and forth.
There they are again.
Yes, there we are. You're alive, Patty.
Dave's posing back there.
Sorry, it's a stupid thing. It just keeps quitting. But praise God, yeah, we're back. So, and I'm glad that those things are going on there. Praise God, we know God's everywhere, and He's just going to keep showing up and showing off, and He's going to show up and He's going to show off tonight in Auburn. So, if anybody is near Auburn, get a hold of us or come to the most. What's
Muckleshoot?
It called?
The Muckleshoot Tribe.
The
Slahal Shed.
Slahal Shed. I have a hard time saying that. So come, it's going to start at 7 o'clock. So we're 2 hours
We'll be there.
You'll be there?
Yeah. In the spirit. In the spirit.
Yeah, we're fueling up the citation. You know that citation? Well, not yet.
We're you streaming it.
Praise
Go
God.
To our website and watch it from our Ustream, too.
Yeah. Amen.
Praise God.
If anybody needs healing, they can just watch it and receive it then.
Amen.
Oh. Well, I just want to announce, too, that we are going to have the Christmas Eve giveaway that we work with my sister and a bunch of other people every year in Des Moines, Iowa, at the Capitol Square. And we're going to, it starts at 5 o'clock, so if you know anybody that is less fortunate and they want to come, they're welcome to come. And Norma's going to sing, woohoo! And then we're going to give away clothes and household items, coats, shoes, blankets, toys, all kinds of stuff. Oh my gosh, last year I couldn't believe all the stuff. My sister said she's knows that 23 people that are going to come help from her end. Praise and God. I don't know how many from our end. I know there's probably going to be at least 10, but sure. probably more than that. I'm still waiting back for different people to answer me. So it's going to be good.
We need some Holy Ghost prayer people just to shake and bake them.
Yeah. Amen. Yeah. We don't want just people to set things up. We want people to go through the crowd and pray for people. You know, last year people were saved and healed and filled with the Holy Spirit. And we want that every year, you know,
yes.
it's not just to give them, material things. It's to give them Jesus. Yeah. So
Amen.
We look forward to it. I swear it is the best day all year. I look forward to this because we get to touch so many lives and people are just like, wow, what group are you? Who are you?
We're the Jesus group.
Amen.
Simple enough.
Yeah, it's like you're just so nice to do this. And, you know, it just makes my day.
What happened at the last place we were at? We just had some other miracles.
Oh, in Sunnydale. You changed channels, honey.
I know. I was no.
Okay. Oh, Lord help. We were in Silverdale. We did a 3-day DHT there. And Fred Palmer, he helped us with some of the training in Auburn and also in Silverdale. He's such a blessing. We just love Fred. He's the state director for Washington. And it was a huge family that got together, that came, that grabbed this message, and there's other people too. But this whole family, the grandma and grandpa, and their kids, and their grandkids, and their great grandkids. Wow, we had a great time with them, and I know one of their vision got better, And
Dean left her body. Two people fell out and just laughing, and they couldn't quit laughing.
Yeah, one lady said, "I don't remember the last time I laughed this hard." So, and they're just on fire for the Lord. It's just so good to get people stirred up, and they get to, you know, it's in a safe setting at the healing service at the end of the DHT. They pray for the sick people and one another, and they get to see the power of God go through them when they pray for the person and hit the other person, and they know it's real. It's happening. Yeah. They've never done it before. It's just amazing.
And we went out to this little country church in the middle of nowhere on a private road where you couldn't find it again. And some people that are in Northern California know that don't always like us real well. I had a prayer team up there. I had them prophesy over us, and they've seen the same thing Patty's seen. You're going to stand in front of large crowds as far as the eye can see, and I think we're going to be helping you.
Amen.
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 Come on, keep declaring. That's it. That's right. Amen.
Yeah, we sure will. Well, we got to pray. Who wants to pray tonight?
Amen. Amen.
You want to pray?
Whatever
God puts on your heart, you're filled with the Holy Spirit now. Just pray for people, declare what you want for them.
Yes.
Then Norma can go next, and then Terry can finish it up.
Praise God.
I'd like to pray for my people.
Yes.
To find God and pray for many miracles to happen to all the people that are sick. I declare good health, and I declare God into their life. And I just want a wonderful healing throughout our community. And I want God to touch each and every one of them and show them that he's real tonight. I want them to see many miracles. And I want them to believe that God is real and that he will hear us when we need him most. And that he will touch the lives that really need touch tonight. Because I've been spreading the word to many people, not just our native, but just the people in the surrounding area, to come and to get prayer and healing. Because I truly believe God is going to be there with us tonight, and we're going to see something that is going to open the eyes of our people.
Yes.
And it's going to give us a wonderful feeling. There's going to be light in our reservation, and there's going to be no more darkness.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Keep praying like that. Keep declaring like that. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Norma?
Praise you, God. We just thank you so much, Lord, for the testimony that Rhonda has shared with us, Lord. It's so uplifting to all of us. And we're praying, Lord, that all of these things shall come to pass, Lord God, that there will be no darkness. Jesus, you came because you are the light of the world.
Jesus,
and we pray for more and more people to see the light, to see the light, to ask you and invite you into their lives, oh God, that lives will be changed and transformed from the youngest child to the oldest person, oh God. Every person in that tribe, Father God, be enlightened and set free. We thank you for the freedom, oh God. And we praise you and thank you, God, for the opportunity on Christmas Eve, Lord, that there will be many testimonies to come, Father God, from that move of your Holy Spirit, that people's lives will be touched and transformed, that they will be the ones that come this year, that next year they will be the ones out teaching and showing people your Spirit, oh God. And we just thank you, God, for all the testimonies. In Jesus' name.
I make more declarations than I do prayers, but I wanted to tell you that my mother was with my great aunt today. My great aunt is 103 years old.
Wow.
And
praise the Lord.
My great aunt set my mother down when she was probably about 16 or 18. She'd given her heart to the Lord at a church, but she prayed with her, led her through the sinner's prayer. And Aunt Edna is 103, and you know what? She was clear as a bell today, and she kept praising God and thanking God for my mom. And, you know, I love my elders, and I thank God because I know it was her prayers and her witnessing to my mother that helped call me and activate me into ministry. And I've been blessed to travel different countries. But here's a declaration. I'm going to repeat the covenant that God gave to us. And what the beautiful thing is that I'm going to set you free, and because, well, I'm going to repeat what Jesus did. It's out of Hebrews, and it says, "This is the new covenant I will make with my people, says the Lord. I will put my laws in their hearts, and I will write them on their minds." Then he says, "I will never again remember their sins and their lawless deeds."
Amen.
And when their sins have been forgiven, there is no need to offer any more sacrifice. That's my declaration for you today. We pray for the generations and the nations, and that you are free by the blood of Jesus, and you don't have to go back into your past. You need to go into your future. You have a glorious future. You talk about a gift. This is the gift that truly honest from God keeps on giving. It's salvation, and you are a new creation. Say new creation.
New creation.
Old things have passed away. All things become new. And God cannot even remember the last time you made a mistake because of the blood of his son, Jesus. Amen. And you declare, "I am a child of God. I am a son of God, and I receive my inheritance." Now, when do you want to receive your inheritance?
20 years ago.
Now. I'll tell you what, my kids, somebody said this week they had the 12 days of Christmas just to keep the kids under control, a gift a day. I'm telling you what, open that package right now. Start walking in your inheritance. Receive the gift of God, the love of God. And as Rhonda spoke so well, receive the power of God, the healing, the signs and wonders. When you take someone's hand, release the power of God. God is, our Father is a living God.
Amen.
And the same power that raised Jesus from the dead quickened Rhonda. She just testified, and it quickens these mortal bodies. That's my declaration for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yes, it's going to be good tonight. I wish you guys were here.
Amen. Amen.
And we got a call today from some people in Texas. They want to come down there. And they said soon, and they said, "Okay, we'll go right from there."
Amen.
Amen. "No, it's almost Christmas. We're going home first. Then we can go."
Amen.
Amen.
We know it's a lot colder in Ankeny, Iowa than Texas, so hopefully we'll be going there soon.
Amen.
Awesome.
If nothing, by the 1st of February, we'll be going. We may be going sooner. Who knows?
Yeah.
So, praise God. Open up those doors. So, if you're a pastor of a church or if you're a ministry that wants us to come in, give us a call. Ryan, can you put my number up there? 515-229-0111. We'd love to come in and spread this, just like we have with you guys and the people in Silverdale and Vancouver, and just get more people on fire for the Lord. You know, it's really helpful if you have your congregation out there working with you, that they're praying for the sick, they're seeing them healed, and they're walking in it. You don't have just the pastor. Anybody can walk in this. The kids are walking in this.
Amen.
Praise God. Mm-hmm. And we want to do the training and do the miracle service and see people healed, that the people in your church don't have to be sick. And, you know, we just want to see that happen. We want to see more people out doing what Jesus told us to do.
Can you imagine if all the money they spent on doctors and insurance, they could put it building the kingdom?
Amen.
You know, I have an announcement before we sign off. You guys are the affordable health care plan. It's Jesus.
Awesome. Yeah.
Yes. Amen. Oh, my gosh, it's 8 o'clock already. Yeah, well, we thank you, Terry and Norma and Michael, for doing our website. He still makes us look good. Praise God. And Ryan and all the rest of the people, Jeff there, Kinsey. And you know what? We'll see you next week, same time, same place, wherever we're coming from. We might actually be home next week. Praise
Woo-hoo!
God.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Blessings.
Thanking God because he's the one that uses us. So praise God. Thank you for all you do. Amen.
Amen.
with me through